Hello, my dear student. Hope you are fine and doing practice for the ray diagrams formed by concave mirror and convex mirror. Today we will study about the next topic, that is new Cartesian sign conventions. Before starting the topic, please do like and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button for further notification. Let's start. So what is new Cartesian sign conventions? It's whenever we want to solve the mirror formula, so we have to put some sign conventions in that. So to solve numericals related to mirror formula, we have to put these signs, or we can say that we have to put these rules to solve the numerical. What are these rules? According to these rules, first is that the principal axis is always considered as like a coordinate system x-axis. So if you are watching, this mirror is there, and what is this? We have to put like this. Mirror is there. This is MN is the aperture, P is the pole. Clear? So this principal axis is considered as the x-axis of the coordinate system. Like this, in maths you have done coordinate system. This was the y-axis, y dash, or we can say that minus x-axis also, x-axis, and we can say that this is x dash axis. So this principal axis is considered as x-axis, and pole is considered as the origin. Clear? So this first of all we have to keep it in the mind. Then next is, object is always placed towards the left. What is the next rule? Ki object is always placed towards the left of the mirror. According to that, whenever the object is placed towards the left of the mirror, so this is like this. So AB is the object which is always placed towards the left of the mirror. So the distances which are towards the left side of the pole are taken as distances towards the left. So what we will take? We will take them negative. Like here also, origin. So which are towards the left, you take them negative. And the distances which are towards the right of the pole, we take them positive. Clear? And the next one is the distances which are, we can say that these are the parallel to the principal axis distances. Clear? And next is, if you are taking above the principal axis, the distances which are above the principal axis means which are perpendicular to the principal axis. Like this, you can see in the coordinate system also, the distances which are perpendicular to x-axis here also. So that is taken as positive. And the distances, like if you will make a ray diagram of this, you will get a distance like here below the principal axis. So they are taken as negative. Means the distances which are below the principal axis are always taken as negative. Here also you can see, either it is in this quadrant or in this quadrant. Y is always negative. So like this, the distances, perpendicular distances which are below the principal axis are taken as negative. And the distances which are above the principal axis, whether on the left side or right side, they are taken as a positive. The horizontal distance means the distance which is parallel to the principal axis and towards the left of the pole are taken as negative. And the distances which are parallel to principal axis and on the right side of the pole are taken as a positive. And these sign conventions are valid for all the situations and for the mirror formula. For every situation, for all spherical mirror, these sign conventions are valid. What does it mean? I am again recalling, like this. So this is, if you are taking a pole in a mirror, so the object is always placed towards the left. The distances which are towards the left are negative. The distances which are towards the right, they are positive. The distances above the principal axis are positive, and the distances which are below the principal axis are negative, and pole is considered as origin. And we will apply these sign conventions to calculate mirror formula or to solve the numericals related to mirror formula. So let's come to know what is mirror formula. Now next is mirror formula. Mirror formula derivation is not given in 10th standard, that you will study in 12th class. Here just we will use the formula directly. The mirror formula is 1 by V plus 1 by U is 1 by F. This is mirror formula. 1 by v plus 1 by u is equal to 1 by f. Where v is equal to image distance. V is equal to image distance. U is equal to object distance. And f is equal to focal length of the mirror. So this is the, we can say that this formula gives a relation between image distance, object distance and focal length of the mirror. Means numerically, whenever focal length of the mirror is given and object distance is given, and it is given in the question that calculate the object image distance. So by this formula we can calculate after applying the new Cartesian sign conventions to that. Clear? So you can consider it, I am simply taking the example like this formula you have done. So I am taking an example of concave mirror. Pole is there. So let us say that focus center. Object is situated beyond center of curvature. Clear? So we have done this case. It will pass through the focus. Another ray will pass through the center of curvature. So we will got an image here. Below this axis. A dash, P dash. So this distance, this one, this PB. PB. So what is PB? U. That is object distance. And I have told to you ki object distance is always, object is always placed towards the left of the mirror. So according to new Cartesian rule, so that is given by U. So U is always negative. Like it is given that object is situated 20 centimeter away from the pole. So we will not write 20. We will write minus 20 to solve the numericals of the mirror. So this is the meaning of new Cartesian sign convention. Now see this B dash, PB dash. What is PB dash? PB dash is image distance. The distance of the image from the pole. So that is image distance. And where it is formed? Again. So it is given by V. And again it is towards the left of the mirror. So again we will take it negative in the sign convention. Now see this AB object. What is AB? It is the height of object. What is this? It is the height of a object. Where it is? It is above the principal axis. So height of object is always positive. Now this real image, which is below the axis, A dash, B dash. So height of image is negative for real images. For real images it is negative because pole is origin. So according to that we have to apply first these rules numerically in our ray diagrams, and then according to that we have to put in the numericals all these things. So later on we will discuss about, similarly you can try for the convex mirror also. And you can find out these distance values, positive, negative. So next we will do about the numericals related to mirror formula. That at that time it will be more clear to you. For today, revise till here. Thank you and have a nice day.